Hey everyone! In this video, we're going to look at the Feberis Pro, which is a GPIO module for the Flipper Zero. It has two sub-gigahertz radios, an NRF24 for mouse jacking and IoT experiments, and an ESP32 with both Wi-Fi and Bluetooth support. It also has a GPS module, which can be used for war driving. Let's get started! Thanks to Lab401 for sending me this module. To support this channel, please order from Lab401 using promo code Derek. It comes with a nice 3D printed cover, which helps protect the GPIO pins when it's not in use. There are three switches to choose which device you want to use. When they're all down, it's the ESP32. And then we move that bottom one up, we're using the NRF24. And then we move up again and we're using the 433 megahertz radio, and then up again in the 900 megahertz radio. So when we push them down, you can see we're at 900. Now we're at 433, NRF24, and the ESP32 plus GPS. There are four external antennas. For sub-gigahertz, we have 433 megahertz, 900 megahertz, and then we have our NRF24 antenna, and then we have our Wi-Fi and Bluetooth antenna. And then inside the case, we have our GPS antenna. And all of the antennas are wired instead of soldered directly to the PCB, which hopefully makes the longevity a little better. Here's a quick demo of the sub-gigahertz radio. I'm receiving on 915 megahertz, and we can see the signal being sent from my wife over on that bench. And this time I'm transmitting on 433.92 megahertz, and you can see my wife over by the fence, and she's able to see that signal. The external radio typically gives me 4 to 6 times the range, and that also means I'm able to pick up the signal anywhere in my house. If you want to open it up, you can use a number 2 hex. And there's just this one hex screw here you have to take out, and then the lid will just come right off. There's little switch covers that are the switches that are going over those micro switches, so make sure you don't accidentally lose those switches. And all of the components are mounted on this side of the printed circuit board. And again, that GPS antenna is underneath. The top sub-gigahertz radio has a range of 855 to 925 megahertz. And that second radio is a range of 431 to 446.5 megahertz. Our NRF24 is at 2.4 gigahertz with a transmit power of 500 milliwatts. The GPS unit supports all kinds of satellites, and it outputs a NMEA signal to the ESP32. Later in this video, I'll show you how you can mirror that data to the Flipper Zero's RX pin so you can show the satellite data in the NMEA app. Here's our ESP32. It's a room edition, which means it supports Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. And the 32UE means it's got an external antenna. And there's a NeoPixel status light connected to pin 25 of the ESP32. On the back of the printed circuit board, there's a recipe for classic Polish pierogi. Be sure to get permission before cooking. When the directions say roll out, I would roll it so it's about 1/8 of an inch thick. When it says cut dough, I'd recommend 3 to 3.5 inch circles. I used a 1-to-1 ratio for mashed potatoes to cottage cheese, and it tasted okay to me. And I think there is such a thing as too much filling. When it says seal, be sure to pinch around all the edges. The boil until they float step took about 6 minutes. Also, they stuck to the bottom of the pan, so you had to kind of shake the pan a little to get them to float.
Whoa! Fire!
If you choose to pan fry, make sure you have a way to put out grease fires, and I recommend also having someone else in the house. Both the ones without and with the filling taste great. You can find the NRF apps under Apps GPIO or Apps GPIO NRF, depending on your firmware. Make sure the device is on 433 sub-gigahertz, not NRF, and then start the application. And then what you're going to do is go ahead and start scanning and then switch the switch to NRF24. And now you can see the data from our NRF radio. Here's another example. We're running the NRF scanner app. We switch back to the 433 megahertz, then start the application. Go ahead and start sniff, which will give you an error, and then flip to the NRF24 radio. And then we'll run the sniff and show the data. So the important thing to remember is to always switch to that 433 and then back to NRF24. Next, we'll look at downloading the ESP32 firmware. So you're going to go to GitHub/BMP Circuits, click on Repositories, scroll down to ESP32 Marauder, click on that, and this is a fork of Just Call Me Coco that supports the device. Under Releases, click on that, and you should see the FeberisPro.bin file. Go ahead and download that. Copy that bin file over to your Flipper Zero, and then go to Apps GPIO, and depending on your firmware, it may be ESP, and then find the ESP Flasher application. We use this application to update our ESP32 to all the different firmwares, such as Marauder, Ghost ESP, Flipper HTTP, Gemini, etc. Go down to Enter Bootloader, and you should get a waiting for download message. Go ahead and click back at that point, and then go to Manual Flash. You do not need to select a bootloader or the partition table. Just go to Firmware A and say OK, and then choose the location where you stored that bin file. So in my case, I stored it here, and it should be named, there we go, ESP32 Marauder, BPM Circuits, and then go to Flash Fast. And this process typically takes about 30 seconds while it flashes your device with the latest firmware. Once you've installed the latest firmware, click back twice, and then go down to Reset Board. And there we go. We've just booted the new firmware. And if we scroll up, we can see that we're on, in my case, version 1.4.4 was the latest. Once we're done with that, go ahead and keep clicking back to back out of the application. And then inside of the ESP folder, we'll run ESP32 Wi-Fi Marauder. And if you flash the Ghost firmware, you would use the Ghost ESP instead. There are a ton of videos about Marauder, so I'm not going to show all that here. Talking Sasquatch does a good job at walking through each of the features. But here you can see we can scan access points, do different attacks like deauth, rickroll. And then for WarDrive, we can WarDrive looking for access points or Bluetooth since we have that special ESP32 room. And this will take advantage of our GPS as well. You can also do things like Evil Portal, which will create a fake login site. Again, only do this in an area where you have permission. We can also do beacon spams and look at our GPS data. And this will show the current latitude, longitude, altitude, and time. I've written a couple projects over on GitHub/JamesonDerek. Click on Repositories, and then click on Flipper Zero Tutorials. In Flipper Zero Tutorials, go GPIO, and then Feberis Pro, and you'll see that there's bin files and source files. The first one is for making the status light blink. And the second one is to mirror your GPS on Flipper Zero's RX pin. In this example, I flashed the LED bin file on my ESP32. And so you can see I've selected the ESP32. So this shows how to control the status light in your own firmware files. Next, let's look at mirroring that GPS data. In momentum, we'll go into momentum, and then down into protocols, GPIO pins, and then for the GPS, switch it to default 1314 instead of 1516. And again, I flashed my ESP32 with that GPS mirror.bin file. And so now we're ready to run the NMEA GPS. Make sure the ESP32 is selected. And we'll go ahead and open it. In a few seconds, we should see it acquire the satellites. And so again, what's happening is our GPS is sending data to the ESP32. And then the ESP32 is sending data on the RX pin of the Flipper Zero. And so that's how the Flipper Zero is able, there we go, we got 7 satellites. That's how it's able to get our GPS data. When you're recording a sub gigahertz file, it will also record that GPS information if you've turned that feature on. Unfortunately, when we use the external CC1101s, we have to disable the ESP32 so there's no GPS data. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and subscribe. And again, thanks to Lab 401 for sending me this device.